Happy May the 4th, everyone. May the force be with you. It is Star Wars Day today, and I am back bringing you a brand new video. So today I was wondering, what video should I do? Should I do a top ranking of every Star Wars movie, talking about whatever my favorite Star Wars scene is and whatnot? Then I decided, why not talk about why I love Star Wars? So this is going to be me pretty much monologuing about my journey as a Star Wars fan, as a movie fan really, and how I've come into loving Star Wars so much that I'm willing to not only just binge watch every movie that's come out, but also really just go online and talk about it for the whole world to see really. My Star Wars journey is a very long journey. I've loved Star Wars since I was very little. I in fact was born in 1999, the same year that The Phantom Menace came out, which is always a pleasure to think of because I'm born the same year that a Star Wars movie came out. Sure, it may be what many people consider to be the worst Star Wars movie, but I don't really care. I loved The Phantom Menace when I was a kid. It was my favorite movie as a kid, and then when I grew up, it eventually became A New Hope. But I remember when I was a kid, I would always go around with this little light, and I would get two blue plastic cylinders and put them on the end of the light, and that would be my lightsaber as a kid. So then I remember going around, boom, boom, with this little light, and it was really fun, and it's because I really enjoyed watching Star Wars. I was exposed to it from a really young age, and I was constantly reminded how much Sikhism, how Sikhs are essentially like the Jedi. And trust me, because I am a Jedi, I'm saying that. And my dad always told me how Sikhs believe in balance. We try not to have materialistic attachments because they hold you back from becoming one with God and whatnot. And obviously all these things are really hard to achieve in the real world, but it was similar attributes which the Jedi had. And I always had that extra connection between my real life religion and the world I could explore on screen. So the first Star Wars movie I ever saw in cinemas was Revenge of the Sith. And I actually don't remember going to watch it or really watching it in cinemas because I was very young at the time and I have a pretty bad memory of really my memories as a child. But I remember my parents telling me about it. I remember watching Revenge of the Sith all the time whenever we'd go on family field trips, really going to wherever in the outback or South Australia, Northern Territory, New South Wales, wherever we were going. We'd get the little portable DVD player, we'd get Revenge of the Sith, and we'd always watch that, me and my sister. And yeah, it's a thrilling movie, and you know, talking about all this kind of stuff, I'm not really sure where to begin when I'm talking about my Star Wars journey, but when I was a young kid, I was, you know, as I was born in 1999, I was born just a few years before 9/11 and the aftermath of the whole attack and everything that came about it. So people would always, you know, when I was a little kid, people would always think that I and my family, my dad, we were terrorists because, you know, more so my dad, because I was a young kid, I didn't have a beard back then and I didn't tie a turban like I did today. But people would go around telling me that I'm the son of Bin Laden, that my dad is Bin Laden, he's a terrorist because he's a brown guy with a beard and a turban, and people were seriously just stereotyping all of us to be terrorists because of how we looked, even though I looked this way because of my religion. At the time, it was really hard to go around in the public and, you know, not be affected by what people were calling you, not be affected by how the world saw you as a threat, as someone who was willing to, you know, just blow up any public place and cause mass terror. And you know, it was hard, you know, seeing my dad, you know, have to deal with it all as well. My dad made sure that we, my family, my sister and I, we did our part in the community and worked with local interfaith communities in trying to promote the idea of Sikhism. And I'm really thankful for that because that helped promote the idea that, you know, we're not terrorists. People are seeing us through this lens which they're making up on their own because of all this terror that's happening. They see one person who's leading it and all his followers, you know, they tie turbans, they brown, they have beards, and they're like, everyone who has that or looks the same is a terrorist. And that really affected me as a child. And, you know, to escape from all these real world things, one of the few things I could do was watch Star Wars. And as a little kid, you see Star Wars and, well, I saw Star Wars and I saw, you know, a young farm boy who grew up to be Luke Skywalker, the Jedi Master. He saved his dad, he brought peace to the world. You see the Mos Eisley Cantina scene and you see that there are all these different aliens, all kinds of sizes, you know, looks, species, and they're all welcome there except for droids. But anyone and everyone, you know, living being in sorts, was welcome in this universe. There was a place for them, whether, you know, they were fighting against the Empire, whether they were like a smuggler, or a crime lord, or really just an everyday citizen, a farmer, who knows what you could be. And this really showed me an escape from the real world where I could be like, you know, I can see myself here. So not only was, you know, I liking Star Wars because, you know, I thought it was a good movie and I thought it was a great universe, but because it was very personal to me. And that's one thing I rarely tell people. Most of the time when someone asks me, oh, why do you like Star Wars? I say, you know, it's a good movie, it's enjoyable and whatnot. You know, I enjoy the franchise, I saw it when I was a kid and whatnot, because sometimes you're not comfortable in saying, well, what I'm saying right now. So Star Wars came to me, I was introduced to it at a time where it helped me a great deal. I could just escape to this world, I could see myself there, I could be inspired, I could have hope, and I could believe that the world would always be better. So that's really why I loved Star Wars when I was so young, because not only was I a person who really got attached to watching characters in movies and whatnot, but it was an escape for me. It was a world where I could go to and live out, you know, see myself instead of seeing myself in this, you know, racist and rude world. And as the years have passed, you know, I keep on telling people that I'm a huge Star Wars fan. And early on, in like the late 2000s, I should say, there was always this stigma that, you know, if you're a nerd, you're not really, you know, you're of like a lower class in a way, because you're a nerd, you're into all these kind of stuff, there's something wrong with you to an extent. And really, you know, I was still open about the fact that I love Star Wars, you know. I kept on telling people, yeah, I'm a Star Wars fan. Whenever I was in school and we had those things where share one interesting fact about yourself, I would say, I love Star Wars, because I do love Star Wars and I'm proud of it, you know. Because to me, it wasn't just a movie, you know, filled with space wizards using laser swords and whatnot. To me, it was something more personal, and most people don't understand that. Most people didn't know that. So then when I would say that, they would either laugh, you know, recognize me as a nerd, or they would just say, you know, how the hell is Star Wars so good, you know? I remember in year 7 as well, so that was like 2011, I'm pretty sure. You know, I said, you know, oh, one interesting thing about myself is that I love Star Wars. And then, you know, people were like, well, the only good Star Wars movies are the Family Guy ones and whatnot. But I was still proud of it, I still continued with it. And the interesting thing happened was that, despite me loving Star Wars so much, I kept on getting, you know, kind of shit for it, but I still loved it. And even though there were no movies at the time, we had the TV show of the Clone Wars, and we even had that 2D animated miniseries of the Clone Wars as well. I really found the characters in the Clone Wars, I found the moments in the Clone Wars to be something I could enjoy a lot. And it came so less of me finding this as well to escape to, while that always will be the case when I watch Star Wars. I go into this other world and I don't really want people to disturb me. I don't want, you know, I try to take out the outside as much as possible. And, you know, watching this TV show, it gave me something a little different, because I was watching this with my family, my sister, my dad, and we were watching the movie, we were watching the TV show, and, you know, now I had something which was a little more family oriented with Star Wars. While Star Wars was always something my family and I did together, because, you know, my dad introduced me to Star Wars, but when I was younger it was more so that personal attachment I had to the world. And the love for Star Wars I had grew from this one personal thing for the most part to something which came personal in a family oriented way, and I loved that about Star Wars. So the Clone Wars ended up becoming my favorite era in Star Wars, and while we weren't getting movies, we got the promise of The Force Awakens coming out in 2015, and because, well, Disney bought Lucasfilm, and really, I kind of didn't like that. While I was excited to get a new Star Wars movie and I was thrilled by the trailers and everything, I kind of hated the idea that Star Wars was no longer my thing because it was becoming something that the general public would go and watch, and that was evident by the amount of money The Force Awakens made and how much my friends actually, you know, went to watch it and they talked about it. And it was weird because I don't really have friends that I can really nerd out with. That's one of the reasons I really love doing this on YouTube, because I just want to start a conversation, you know? If you want to just let me know anything, you just let me know in the comment section. I reply and I'll start a conversation. I don't care how long it is. I tried doing that with Facebook groups and whatnot, and I didn't really have any real life friends to nerd out with, so I did it with Facebook groups. I keep on messing that up. But then I was always like sending out like paragraphs. I was like this, that. And most people were just sending out like one lines and they weren't creating that conversation, and it really wasn't there. So then there was an opportunity that could happen now that Star Wars was becoming very general. But at the same time, I know it wouldn't happen because there would always be that stigma that this kind of stuff is for nerds and it's whatnot, not for like the general public in a sense. But in Disney buying Lucasfilm, it kind of took away from the whole personal attribute I had for Star Wars, because they purposely tailored the films to be less orientated to the Star Wars community and more so opened up to the general community. And while that's not bad, you know, I always try to get new fans into Star Wars, it kind of alienated me a little bit. It doesn't help that, you know, in 2017, we got the Star Wars The Last Jedi, and in all the hoo-ha about what happened with that movie, it was very disappointing. I came out loving The Force Awakens, and you know, it has its flaws, but it did what it had to do, and it got people interested in Star Wars movies again, and it got the general public into it. It got, you know, Star Wars fans hyped for more movies, even though I love the prequels. You know, there are a lot of people out there who didn't like them as much as they could have. But so this Force Awakens did that job. And then when The Last Jedi came around, you know, Disney employees, you know, the actors and some fans, you know, really just hated on people that didn't like the movie. So for me, a person who doesn't like the movie, when I, you know, go online and I see the director calling, you know, people complain about the movie or don't like it, man babies, when I see the fact that an actress, you know, gets off social media, just happens to be an Asian actress, and then everyone who doesn't like the character is called, you know, a misogynistic racist. You know, I get that label now because I don't like the movie and I didn't like her character and whatnot. But the thing is, that isn't what I should be feeling as a Star Wars fan. I can, you know, freely dislike something the way people dislike the prequels. What did George Lucas do? People didn't like Jar Jar Binks. George Lucas toned down Jar Jar Binks in episode 2, and eventually he only had that one scene, I'm pretty sure, in episode 3. So he listened to the fans. People wanted to create, you know, George Lucas versus the people. He gave them permission to make that. Created Fanboys, all the Robot Chicken parodies. He allowed them to do this kind of stuff, the Family Guy stuff. But then with Disney, you know, you say that you don't like something and you get attacked for it. So, despite my love for Star Wars, it started to turn into a little bit tainted by what was going on and what is still going on kind of in this Disney Lucasfilm era of Star Wars. So while the general public may be reinvigorated into the Star Wars mentality and, you know, getting into Star Wars, you know, some fans like myself were attacked. And for me to be called a misogynistic racist, you know, I experienced these things. To me, you know, racism kind of helped my love for Star Wars grow. So how does it feel? Like, can you imagine how it feels when, you know, I'm called a racist for not liking a character, and, you know, I'm being called this by the people who make the movies, by people behind it, you know, by some fans who think you're wrong in disliking this movie, and really the direction that the film is franchise is going in. With all that said, it's not like I don't love Star Wars as much as I used to. I will forever love Star Wars because of how much it means to me on a, you know, personal level from when I was young. I just, you know, want to get that out there, that my Star Wars journey is one of highs and lows. starting off from when I was really young and, you know, experiencing a lot of struggles, Star Wars was that escape to a new world. And, you know, I'm always thankful to George Lucas and all the creators behind it for, you know, what they did. And, you know, whatever happens now, it can never take away from that love I have for Star Wars. So that is why. Sorry, give me a second. So, despite all that has been said, that is my Star Wars journey. I'm sure I've missed out on a few points here and there, because really, it's very personal and raw what I've just said, and I just wanted to get that out there on May the 4th. You know, a special day for Star Wars fans, a special day for, you know, the whole world, because they recognize it as Star Wars Day. I remember when I was doing my placement last year at a school, they all recognized May the 4th as Star Wars Day. They're going around saying Star Wars Day, Star Wars Day, and you know, that brings a smile to me, because, you know, Star Wars Day is being recognized by everyone. So, despite this being something that was quite emotional and for the most part, leaning a little to the more negative view of my struggles and whatnot, I want you all to know that, you know, I love Star Wars. I'm a Star Wars fan. I will and always will be. Because despite where everything goes, despite on how much I may be personally attacked or in ways rudely commented on because of my not liking a certain perspective of a film or film in general, I will forever love Star Wars, the world George Lucas created, and the world which I could escape to.